Hello everyone, I am T.
And I'm Lucas.
Today we'll teach you vocabulary for shopping.
And how to have a conversation while shopping.
Are you ready?
Let's begin. Let's go over some shopping vocabulary. Number one, cash. Some people pay with cash, while other people pay with a credit card or a debit card. For example, I paid cash for my coffee this morning. Cash. Number two is change. Change is money that you will receive back after paying with cash. For example, I received $5 in change after I paid for my groceries. Change. Number three is cashier or clerk. A cashier or clerk is someone who helps me to check out at the grocery store. For example, I said goodbye to the cashier when I was leaving the store. Cashier, or a synonym, is clerk. Number four is cheap. Cheap means something that is not very expensive. For example, the clothes that I bought at the department store were cheap. Cheap. Word number five is pricey. Pricey means something that is expensive. For example, the new ring that I bought at the jewelry store was very pricey. Pricey. Number six is bargain. Bargain is when you pay less money for an item. For example, I got a great bargain on a new dishwasher. Bonus. Bargain. Number seven is discount. Discount is when you pay less of a percentage for an item. For example, 25% off or 50% off, even better. When I went to the store, I got a 25% discount. Discount. Number eight is on sale. When you go shopping, you might see a sign that says on sale. So, what does that really mean? On sale means that you will pay less money for an item than normal. An item that is $15 might be selling for $12. When I went shopping, I bought a new TV because it was on sale. On sale. Word number nine is credit card. A credit card is just one way to pay for your items. When you have a credit card, you will have to pay it off, which means you will have to transfer money from your bank account to your credit card and pay off the money. So be careful. Credit card. I got a new credit card in the mail. And word number 10 is debit card. A debit card is another way that you can pay for items. However, a debit card will be with your bank account, so the money will come out of your bank account automatically. It is different than a credit card. Last weekend, I used my debit card at the coffee shop. Debit card. Number 11 is receipt. A receipt is a piece of paper that the cashier will give you after you buy items. It will contain what you bought and how much you paid for your items. So make sure that you don't lose your receipt. When I went to the store to return my jacket, I gave the cashier my receipt. Receipt. Number 12 is bags. Sometimes when you go shopping, you will take your own bags, but sometimes the store will give you bags, or you will pay a small fee for bags. When I left the grocery store, I noticed that I had forgot one bag. Bags. Number 13 is aisles. Aisles are like walkways that are located in the store. You will find shelves on both sides of the aisle. When I was walking down the aisle, I dropped something on the floor. Aisles. Number 14 is shelves. On the shelves in grocery store, you will see many items. They are located in the aisles. When I was looking for salt in the grocery store, I couldn't find it on the shelf. Shelves. Number 15 is barcodes. A barcode contains special numbers, and the cashier will scan the barcode to see how much the item is. When the cashier scanned the barcode on my new shirt, it told her the shirt was $15.95. Barcodes. Good work.
Now listen to each conversation dialogue and answer the question that goes with it.
A woman is looking for a shoe store.
Excuse me, I'm looking to buy a new pair of shoes. Can you recommend a store nearby?
Well, there are a few shoe stores on this street, and there's a large shoe shop a few blocks away that has good bargains.
Can you tell me how to get to the larger store?
Yeah, sure. Just walk 2 blocks down Smith Street, turn left at the library, and it's right there next to the coffee shop. You can't miss it. They have a big sign out front.
Okay, thanks for your help.
You're welcome.
Bye. So, which word did you hear in the conversation? Barcode. Expensive. Credit card or bargain? Yes, the word bargain is mentioned in the conversation. Now, please listen to the conversation one more time with full text.
A woman is looking for a shoe store.
Excuse me, I'm looking to buy a new pair of shoes. Can you recommend a store nearby?
Well, there are a few shoe stores on this street, and there's a large shoe shop a few blocks away that has good bargains.
Can you tell me how to get to the larger store?
Yeah, sure. Just walk 2 blocks down Smith Street, turn left at the library, and it's right there next to the coffee shop. You can't miss it. They have a big sign out front.
Okay, thanks for your help.
You're welcome.
Bye.
The woman now is at the shoe store.
Excuse me, how much are these runners?
Oh, just give me a moment and I'll check for you. They are $229.
Oh, that's a bit pricey. I'm wondering if you have anything on sale?
Yeah, we do, but on another shelf. Would you like to go over to the other aisle with me?
Sure.
These pairs are 40% off this week. It's a good deal.
Oh, I like this pair. Do you have any in a size 8?
I think so, but let me go check.
Okay, thanks.
Here you go. You can try them on.
Wow, they look good. I'll take them. Where can I pay?
Oh, the cashier is just over there.
Great. So, which word did you hear in the conversation? A. Aisle. B. Shelf. C. Cashier. D. All of the above. Yes, all of the above. So now please listen to the conversation again.
The woman now is at the shoe store.
Excuse me, how much are these runners?
Oh, just give me a moment and I'll check for you. They are $229.
Oh, that's a bit pricey. I'm wondering if you have anything on sale?
Yeah, we do, but on another shelf. Would you like to go over to the other aisle with me?
Sure.
These pairs are 40% off this week. It's a good deal.
Oh, I like this pair. Do you have any in a size 8?
I think so, but let me go check.
Okay, thanks.
Here you go. You can try them on.
Wow, they look good. I'll take them. Where can I pay?
Oh, the cashier is just over there.
Great.
The woman is now at the cashier counter. Hi, how are you today?
I am good, thanks.
Is this everything for you?
Yep, that's everything.
Okay. Oh, sorry, the barcode is not scanning properly. I'll just have to punch it in here by hand.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, including tax, that will be $172.65. Credit or debit?
Actually, I have cash and a coupon too, with a 10% discount.
Oh, okay. So your total now is $155.40.
Here's $200.
Great, and $44.60 is your change. Would you like the receipt with you or in the bag?
I'll take it, thanks.
Here you go, have a good day.
Thank you, you too. So, which words did you hear in the conversation? A. Barcode, discount, receipt. B. Barcode, bargain, receipt. C. Cashier, barcode, receipt. D. Change, bargain, receipt. So, A is the correct answer. Now, please listen to the conversation and the three words again. Barcode, discount, receipt. Okay?
The woman is now at the cashier counter. Hi, how are you today?
I am good, thanks.
Is this everything for you?
Yep, that's everything.
Okay. Oh, sorry, the barcode is not scanning properly. I'll just have to punch it in here by hand.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay, including tax, that will be $172.65. Credit or debit?
Actually, I have cash and a coupon too, with a 10% discount.
Oh, okay. So your total now is $155.40.
Here's $200.
Great, and $44.60 is your change. Would you like the receipt with you or in the bag?
I'll take it, thanks.
Here you go. Have a good day.
Thank you, you too.
The woman is now at the store and returning an item. She's talking with a clerk in customer service.
Excuse me, I'd like to return this pair of shoes because they hurt my feet.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Sure, I can help you. Do you have a receipt?
Yes, I do. Here it is.
Perfect. This will just take a few minutes. Oh, I see that you paid in cash, but I don't have that much cash in the till. Can I just put it back on your debit card?
Yes, sure, no problem. Here's my debit card.
Okay, so that's done. I just need you to sign the receipt for the return.
Okay, where can I sign?
Oh, right here, on the line.
Got it.
Great, and sorry again about the shoes. Have a nice day.
That's okay. Take care.
Now, which words did you hear in the conversation? A. Receipt, credit card, customer. B. Bargain, cash, return. C. Discount, cash, cashier. D. Receipt, cash, return. Yes, D is the correct answer. Now, please listen to the conversation again and listen to the three words carefully. Receipt, cash, and return.
The woman is now at the store and returning an item. She's talking with a clerk in customer service.
Excuse me, I'd like to return this pair of shoes because they hurt my feet.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Sure, I can help you. Do you have a receipt?
Yes, I do. Here it is.
Perfect. This will just take a few minutes. Oh, I see that you paid in cash, but I don't have that much cash in the till. Can I just put it back on your debit card?
Yes, sure, no problem. Here's my debit card.
Okay, so that's done. I just need you to sign the receipt for the return.
Okay, where can I sign?
Oh, right here, on the line.
Got it.
Great, and sorry again about the shoes. Have a nice day.
That's okay. Take care.
So, I hoped you learned some important vocabulary today for shopping and how to have a conversation while shopping. Remember that the dialogues provided in this video are examples, but you might find they are useful as you can use many sentences, questions, and words when finding a store, buying something in the store, talking to a cashier, or returning an item. Thank you for watching our video today. Please subscribe to this channel and share this video with your family and friends. And we hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye.